call me Ishmael. Some years ago, never mind how long precisely, having little or no money in my purse and nothing particular to interest me on shore, I thought I would sail about a little and see the watery part of the world.
To see, are you?
Aye, that I am.
Ship's mate, I suppose.
No.
A passenger then?
Oh, not very likely. A passenger needs a wallet. That's just a slice of leather when there's nothing in it.
A commodore then? Or a cook?
No, a simple sailor. Jumping from spar to spar like a grasshopper in the May Meadow. Very much like a slave, you might say. But who isn't a slave, huh? Tell me that.
Well, I suppose you're going whaling then.
Aye. Would you be having a room then for a simple sailor, Mr. Coffin, is it?
Oh, hey, you've no objection to sharing a blanket with a simple harpooner.
A harpooner? Well, I'd rather put up with half any decent man's blanket than wander further on so bitter a night. Could that be him, sir? The harpooner?
No, that's Mr. Perth and the rest of the grabber's crew. Just landed. Liquor's already gone to their heads. Mr. Perth, off looking to board another ship, are you?
That'll be fun, Wes.
Step on him. Oh, what about you, dear?
That Mr. Stubb ain't seen a skirt in nearly 2 years. Well, step lively, lad. I haven't got all night. Oh, this whale oil's getting a bit low. Best refill it tomorrow.
Seems a trifle small for two grown men.
Well, if you're gonna go whaling, better get used to that sort of thing. Why, look at that bed. It's the largest one in the house. Sal and me slept in that bed the night we were spliced. Plenty of room.
Mind you, I'm not complaining, Mr. Coffin. It's just that I'd like to know the sort of man I'd be sharing it with.
Oh, well, it's almost Sunday. That harpooner likely anchored someplace else for the night. You make yourself comfortable. Mister, what's your name?
They call me Ishmael.
Ishmael. Sleep well.
The devil is he? Speak! Ye don't speak, I kill ye!
Landlord! Mr. Coffin!
Speak, I tell ye! Or damn me, I kill ye!
Here, Queequeg! You stop that!
Why didn't you tell me that this harpooner I'd be sharing a bed with is a bleeding cannibal, for God's sake!
Listen to me, Queequeg. You savvy me, I savvy you, no? This man sleep here in this bed with you.
No.
You sabi?
Me sabi plenty. Get in. Get in. Get in. Anna!
Thank you. No. Well, all right.
Oh, thunder there, no oil.
Quick, wake up, you big savage oaf. In the name of goodness, wake up. Must be dreaming of a savage wife. Whatever savage place he escaped from. Good morning to you, big king of the typhoon snore. Tihe Moriora!
No one here's in any more privileged position than any other.
We've not gone to sea yet, where a lowly sailor's got to wait on a second mate like this booby here to help himself before he can have any food. Or this greasy baboon over here.
So eat, laddie.
Yes, indeed, ma'am.
Put that thing away. It's good Nantucket Christians will take you for the devil himself.
What do you say?
For God's sake, it's a man's head. A very dead real man, too. Nantucketers don't carry their dead around in bags, they bury them. Don't you know that?
Aye, Nantucketers buy them, too, I tell you, for many gold coins. Me, Yojo, tell you what ship Queequeg and D ship out on. Yojo and D, sabi?
You're saying your Yojo wants me to choose a ship. Is that what you mean?
Aye.
So will you be shipping out with me then? Is that what you're trying to tell me?
Aye, Ishmael.
Quick, wait. Stop. Avast there, mate. Listen, my friend, this is simply out of the question. What the devil's the matter with you?
Not one ship out with Queequeg.
No, I mean, yes, of course I do. It's just that you'd be better suited to pick out a whaler that's best fitted to carry both of us, not I. And I shall certainly not take your money. Queequeg, listen. I fear I must make a confession. I used to be a school teacher. Do you know what that is?
Aye, missionary.
No, not exactly. It's what I'm trying to say is I've never jumped a spar in my life.
Ishmael no sailor.
Aye, me no sailor. It's just that I have this burning desire to go to sea.
Mi yojo sabi, Ishmael big ship. Ishmael big ship.
Next!
She's an old ship. Preparing for a long voyage, I gather.
Aye. She be long seasoned ship.
Look at the whale teeth. Something a bit melancholy about her, if you ask me. Well, I suppose Yojo has made his choice for us. Beg pardon, sir. Might this be the captain?
Supposing it be, what do ye want with him?
Well, I was thinking of shipping.
You're no Nantucketer. What do ye know about whaling?
Nothing, sir. But I want to see what whaling is. I want to see the world.
Can't you see the world from where ye stand, young man? You want to see what whaling is, do ye? Are ye man enough to pitch a harpoon down a live whale's throat, then jump after it?
Well, I am, sir, if it should be absolutely indispensable that I do so.
Well, I'll tell ye this much. There's death in this business, and it can bundle a man quite quickly into eternity. Does that frighten ye?
No, sir, it does not.
See. Then have ye clapped eyes yet on Captain Ahab?
Captain Ahab? Who is Captain Ahab?
Who is Ahab? Who is this Peleg?
He says he's our man, Bildad. He wants to ship.
Oh, do you now?
I do, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You look sort of soft in the chest, Peleg. Captain Ahab is the captain of this ship, young fellow.
I thought I was speaking to the captain.
You're speaking to Captain Bildad. I am Captain Peleg. We are the owners of this fine specimen. And it is our job to see to it that she is fitted out with all her needs, including, sir, a crew of goodly experience.
Where is this Captain Ahab?
What do you want with him?
I would like to see him.
He won't always see me, so I rather doubt he'll see you.
Ahab's been to colleges, as well as amongst the cannibals. Been used to deeper wonders than the waves.
This is my friend, Queequeg. He wants to ship out, too.
Quahog doesn't look like much of a Christian to me.
Well, he's killed more whales than you can count.
Captain. You see him small dark spot on masthead there. You see him? Well, suppose he one way alive. Dead will be dead!
Quick, Peleg.
Look here, we'll give you a 90th percent. Now, that's a higher cut of the ship's whale oil cargo than we've ever given to any harpooner. So, what say ye?
What be about me, mate?
Oh, all right, we'll sign him on too, but you earn only a fifth of what he gets.
Shipmates! Come hither!
What do you want, old man?
Have ye ships in that ship, then? Have ye?
Pequod. Why, yes, we have. We just signed the articles.
The articles, eh? And nothing in there about your souls. No! Perhaps you haven't got any. No matter. I know plenty of men haven't got a soul. Good luck to them. Better off for it, some of them. Soul's sort of a fifth wheel on a wagon, don't you think?
What are you jabbering about?
Oh, but he's got enough to make up for the rest of us. Plenty more than enough he has.
Come along, Queequeg. This fella's broken loose from his moorings.
I'm telling you about old Thunder. Haven't seen old Thunder yet, have you?
Who's old Thunder?
Captain Leo. Haven't seen him yet, have you? No, I didn't think so. Did they tell you about him?
I know all I need to know.
All about him? You sure now? It is all you need to know ever enough, I ask you. So you've shipped then, have you? Name's down on paper.
Well, what's to be with me? And again, perhaps it won't. Anyhow, it's all fixed. All been arranged. Has been for a long time.
What? What's been fixed? What are you blathering about?
The prophecy, matey! The prophecy of the Pequod! All aboard her will perish.
Save one man.
All but one. Didn't know that, did you, mitties? Did you? Did you?
Let's go, Queequeg. Put this fool to his ravings.
All but one! All but one!
Don't take it to heart. He's just some crazy old loon.
All but one!
All but one. All but one.
Ishmael would be a soul.
Soul? Wow. That's a difficult question. You believe in God? Like a big chief above all men?
Like your jaw.
I reckon so, but... but bigger than that, like a captain of the stars. I can't explain it to you, but I can show you. Father Mapple. He used to be a harpooner.
Good morning, shipmates.
Good morning, Father Mapple.
God hath prepared a great fish to swallow up Jonah. Book of Jonah. First chapter, last verse. God called upon Jonah to cry out against wickedness. But instead, Jonah fled from his command. Why? Why did Jonah willfully disobey God? Because he thought it was too hard. Too hard. Why, all the things that God would have us do are hard. Hence, he commands more often than he tries to persuade. He knows that if we obey God, we disobey ourselves. That is hard. Hard because we cannot flee from his command, as Jonah tried to do. Hard because God is everywhere. There is no hope of escaping him. Now, imagine poor Jonah skulking, prowling about the ships at Joppa like a vile burglar, and he bargains a passage, hurrying to cross the seas He thinks that a ship made by men will carry him to countries where God does not reign. Now the time of tide has come. The ship casts off her lines, sets away across the great wide ocean. But the sea rebels. It will not bear its wicked burden. A dreadful storm comes on, the wind shrieks and howls. Wave upon wave leaps into the ship, roaring fore and aft, fore and aft, until the ship is like to break. Terror upon terror runs through the souls of the men. They mark the stranger, suspicious of the god, fugitive from the moment he came aboard. They now blame him for the great tempest that is upon them. And now behold Jonah, seized upon like an anchor and cast forth into the sea. And God awaits him, comes upon him in a mighty whale, clamps all his ivory teeth about him, and swallows him whole into the belly of hell, and dives 10,000 fathoms down to living gulfs of doom. And there, far beyond the reach of any earthly sound, Jonah cries out his repentance. Not by begging for deliverance, no, but by praise in God for his just punishment. And the Lord speaks to the great fish, and from the shudder and cold and blackness of the deep, the whale lifts his great head and comes breaching up toward the warm sun and all the delights of earth and air, and vomits Jonah upon the dry land. And ever after, Jonah preached the truth in the face of falsehood. Woe to him whose good name is more to him than goodness. But oh, shipmates, delight afar, far, inward and upward delight is to him who, against the proud captains and commodores of this earth, stands forth his own inexorable self. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, may we strive to be thine more than to be the world's or our own. Here we die, we leave eternity to thee.
Are you that green in the gills?
Not that green, sir.
Then pull! What are you looking at, you dumb painted savage?
He's looking at a dumber one, I'd say. Hold masthead! Hold! We'll be sighting for whale from sunup to sundown. So if you see them, split your lungs. Do you hear?
Activating yard there. Uphill! Hurt the life boy!
Back the main yard there! Back the
help! Help me! Help me! Back the trail! Look below! Up the hill! Set your gown sail! Aye, sir! Stand by the Dutch thistle!
Ishmael!
One hand for the ship, Mr. Ishmael, and one hand for yourself.
Aye, aye, sir. I don't think it proper to make jest of another man's peril.
Ah, but you'd be wrong. Laughter is the final consequence of everything. The only comfort a man has, and the wisest.
Easiest, you mean?
The only comfort, shipmate, and the wisest, let me tell you. Wise stop, that's what they call me, 'cause whatever happens, I go to it laughing.
Just don't ever let fighting flies catch you laughing at him. So, what are we gonna do with this pup? Your own mother would make a better sailor.
I tried my best, sir.
Then try this. Swap the deck, since that's all you're good for.
Excuse me, sir. Will Catton make an appearance, sir?
This fair weather should bring him forth, Mr. Stone.
Shanty man! Give us a good song to speed us on. Shake a leg, Pip.
Cape Cod girls don't have no cold.
Heave away, haul away.
Codfish bones,
and we're bound away for Australia.
So heave her up, my bully, bully boys.
Heave away, haul away.
Man, don't you make a noise.
And we're bound away for Australia.
Australia, fool!
Good of the whole squad, sir.
Captain's orders. Mind your own business.
Ship with no captain. You don't know this.
Will we see a whale soon, I wonder?
We will. And you'll soon not forget it. You haven't lived long, monkey, till you've raised a whale.
We'll be enjoying our sea voyage, then, would we, Mr. Pup? On your knees! Make a sailor of you yet, or by gore, I'll have your skin to the yardarm. Cape Cod girls don't have no cones.
Heave away, haul away.
Comb their hair with the codfish bones.
And we're bound away for Australia.
Blast! Chowder for breakfast, chowder for supper.
This swill ain't fit for a dog.
Mind your tongue, Swabby, or I'll cut it off and add it to the pot.
Add that, cook.
Maybe it'll improve the flavor.
Give it.
What are you looking at? Nick!
Say, Carpenter.
Yeah.
Where do you keep your rum these days? I'm itching for a taste.
What rum? It's against ship's orders, you know that.
Look at them two lovebirds.
Careful of your hand, mate.
Your slave there might be mistaken for supper.
Queequeg no slave. Queequeg son of the chief.
Pardon me, your majesty.
Hail to thee, prince of savages!
You pagans should teach us Christians the art of kindness.
No matter. Queequeg and ye friends.
That is ye sons of bachelors. We ain't the captain, after all.
What, Captain? He don't exist.
You're in a sad pickle, lad.
What do you say we open some grog, ease his growing pains?
Nay, not without permission of the captain.
Hell with permission. Move aside!
Now, see here, that's my medicine!
Yeah, some potent medicine, I'll bet!
No medicine for you, Mr. Flask. What say we christen our new pup, gentlemen?
Aye, Mr.
Come here, boy. Drink now, it'll ease the pain. Come on. And another. Come on, you may have a dry spell for a long time to come.
Aye, that's a manly way. Easy,
well, don't.
Easy, this ain't for you. Give me the mug. Oh, to it, young pup. You drink to your first whale kill. Drink. Drink. Drink.
Drink.
Drink.
Drink.
Drink.
Drink.
Drink.
Drink.
Drink.
Drink.
Drink.
Drink.
Drink.
Drink.
Shh. Cut your size ends.
He lost that leg to a whale, so I hear. Devoured it was. Chewed up by the most monstrous fish that ever chipped a boat.
Aye. Terrifying creature, they say. And fearful angry.
Well, no whale is ever happy to be hunted, eh? And I wouldn't want a man in my boat who ain't afeard of.
And I wouldn't want one that was. Why, I've lowed for sperm whale from a leaking ship off Cape Horn.
What about Captain Ahab?
Ahab? He's hunted more whale than all of us put together.
I killed 15 of them between a sunrise and a sunset.
What about the whale that took his leg? Did he kill that one too?
I don't know about that. But what I do know, pup, is that a fair-sized sperm whale can ram, shiver, and sink a ship in a matter of seconds.
Even a man of war.
And they thirst for human blood.
Sharks are so afraid of them that they dash themselves into rocks just to flee a whale's wake.
Bitch, bitch, bang, bang. I've heard all that chat now makes me jingle all over.
No, no. Get in!
Mr. Stubb.
First watch! All hands on deck! First, look out!
This man,
Ishmael, first watch. Ishmael.
Come on, first watch, take a leg.
Right. Now, hold still, you mongrel. You'll end up with a flat ear. Oh, I've never missed. Here. Come with me.
All hands on deck! Come on, ye solemn rogues! Cease your preening! You're on morning lookout, sailor. Get aloft.
Beg your pardon, sir. Quick, go aloft.
Nay, every man must take his turn. And this young mother's boy must earn his salt. Up to it.
Aye, sir.
Legs, man! Legs, jump to it!
Cruel taskmaster, Mr. Stubb.
Aye, but we'll make a seaman of him yet, sir. Keep your weather eye open! And look sharp!
Mr. Stubb!
Who are them funny-looking boys?
I don't know.
Don't like the look of them. Pip, get below!
Mr. Starbuck.
Sir.
Call everybody aft, Mr. Starbuck.
All hands aft!
All hands aft!
You heard, Mr. Stubb? Get you aft! All hands aft!
All hands aft!
Mr. Starbuck! Everybody, you hear?
Hold on to mastheads. Hold on your mastheads.
Masters! Below!
Masters! Get thee below! Move it! Ye lie lovers!
On deck, sir! Shut her up!
Look at him, Flask. There's something like a chick inside him, pecking at his shell, fighting to get out.
All the men are assembled, sir.
What do ye do when ye see a whale, men?
Sing out for him, sir!
Out for him, sir!
Good. What next?
Blow the boats and after him, sir! Ha!
And what tune do you pull to in your whaleboats as you go after him?
Dead whale or a sunk boat, sir?
Aye, sir!
Look at this. You see this? This is an ounce of Spanish gold.
$16 piece, Mr. Stubb. Look there. You see it? Look, man. You see it? You see it?
Oh, yeah.
See that? You see that, man?
Hand me your top maul, Mr. Carpenter.
Sir.
One good strong iron nail. Whosoever of ye raises me a white-headed whale.
White?
White?
Aye, Mr. Flask. White-headed. With a wrinkled brow and a crooked jaw. Whosoever of ye raises me that snow-white whale. With holes punctured in his starboard fluke. I say, whosoever of ye raises me that accursed whale. He shall have this gold ounce.
Must be the whale folks call Moby Dick, hey, Captain?
Moby Dick? Do ye know the white whale, then?
Aye. That whale has an odd spout, too. Mighty large and bushy, with white wool. That be the one, Captain.
Queequeg sabi him. Him got many spear irons in him hide, Captain. All twiskity
like twisted metal. Corkscrews. Aye, the harpoons do lie all twisted in him like so many corkscrews. Aye, Dagoo, his spout is big, like a whole shock of wheat, thick as a pile of Nantucket wool. Aye, Testego, by death and devils, that white whale is Moby Dick. It is Moby Dick you've seen! Moby Dick.
Captain Ahab.
Was it not Moby Dick that took off their leg?
Aye, Mr. Stabler. Aye. Aye, my heart is all. 'Twas Moby Dick that dismasted me. Moby Dick that reaped away my limb like a mower a blade of grass. Moby Dick brought me to this dead stump I stand on now. Made him poor pagan lover of me forever and a day. Moby Dick. And I will chase that white whale round Good Hope and round the Horn, around the Norway maelstrom and perdition's flames before I give him up. This is what you've shipped for, men. Chase that white whale on both sides of land and over all the oceans till he spouts black blood and rolls fin out. Say, men, will you splice hands on it? I think you do look brave.
Aye, aye!
A sharp eye for the white whale!
Sharp spear for Moby Dick!
Aye!
Aye,
God bless you, men. God bless you. Steward, go draw a great measure of grog.
A great measure! Why the long face, Mr. Starbuck? You not want to chase the white whale? Are you not game for Moby Dick?
Oh, I am game, sir. I am game for his crooked jaw. I am game for the jaws of death, if that's part of the business we came for.
Captain, I'm here to hunt whales, not my commander's vengeance. How many barrels of oil will your vengeance yield? I ask you.
Is money to be the measure of everything we do? Then let me tell you, my vengeance will fetch a great premium here!
What do you wish of me, Captain?
Help me strike a fin. Not an impossible nor a wondrous task for you, the best lance of all Nantucket. Surely you, of all this crew, will not hold back. Speed, man. Well, your silence speaks for you. The measure.
The measure, man! The measure! Drink and pass! Short drafts, long swallows, my heart.
Tis hot as Satan's hoof.
Round with it, boys. Round. Well said, tis almost drained here.
Have a drink for the men, sir.
Give me another.
Ow.
Here's a hollow. Thus, brimming life is gulped and gone.
Ow. Hear me, my braves. Let me revive a noble custom of my fisherman fathers before me. Blacksmith, the irons.
I have.
Mates, attend me.
Flank me here. You harpooner, stand there, your irons in your hands. And mariners all. Now, mates, cross your lances full in front of me. Steward, hold them while I fill.
Mend the murderer's chalices. Touch them. Ah, Mr. Starbuck. You become partners in an indissoluble league. Now, drink ye, mates. Drink ye, harpooners, ye that stand the bow of the whaleboat. Drink and swear. Death to Moby Dick.
Death to Moby Dick!
Drink and swear! May God hunt us all if we do not hunt Moby Dick to his death!
Mr. Starbuck, the deed is done.
Death to Moby Dick!
Death to Moby Dick!
Stop your savage yelling!
Oh.
When the moonlight soothed me. No more. This lovely light lights not me. All loveliness is anguish to me now. Damned most subtly and malignantly. Damned in the midst of paradise. What business have I with pleasure? Any pleasure.
Is it Mermaid's Land?
Whales, sir. They're singing to each other.
Go to bed now, Pip.
Permission to enter?
Aye.
Captain, you sent for me, sir.
Mr. Starbuck, we are inexorably bound together for the duration of this voyage. We are men of intelligence shipping with savages. We need not be strangers.
I do not wish that, Captain. I am tied to thee.
Good. Good. Here. Here, see. The migratory route of the sperm whale. No ship ever sailed its course by any chart with one tithe of such marvelous precision. From the Azores to St. Helena, around the Cape, and on to Java and the Sea of Japan.
Time and tide flow wide, sir. Moby Dick has the round, watery world to swim in.
I know his latitudes. I know his sightings. I know the driftings of his food. From the Seychelles ground to Volcano Bay.
Here lies Nantucket, where our wives and children will be waiting. They'll carry the wee babes up the hill to catch first glimpse of these sails. Your wife and son will be among them, Captain, and we must not disappoint them. I am no crusader after perils, sir. My course is set to return safely home with a full hold. 'Tis the object of our endeavor.
Sir, till this be done, my boy's face is to me as the palm of this hand, a lipless, unfeatured blank. All objects, man, are but as pasteboard masks, behind which some unknown but still reasoning thing puts forth the moldings of its features. If man will strike, strike through the mask! How else can the prisoner escape except by thrusting through the wall?
The white whale is this wall, sir? This mask?
He tasks me. He heaps me. I see in him outrageous strength with inscrutable malice.
It was a dumb brute who took off your leg, Captain. He smote thee from blindest instinct.
be the White Whale agent or be the White Whale principal, I will wreak my hate upon him.
'Tis madness to be thus enraged. To seek vengeance on a dumb thing is blasphemous.
What I've done, I will. And what I will, I will do. This act was rehearsed by you and me a billion years before this ocean rolled. Talk not to me of blasphemy, man. I'd strike the sun if it insulted me. I am the prophet and the fulfiller. Who's over me?
You're pale.
Oh, you think me mad.
Forgive me, Captain. Forgive me.
I'm not mad. I'm madness maddened.
You are my captain. But I am not much for fighting a fish that too much persists in fighting me, sir. I am here on this critical ocean to kill whales for my living, not to be killed by them for theirs. Sir.
Steward, my glass.
Boy, you can understand that there's a whole school of them.
There go flukes!
Ready to lower boats, sir.
All right, lower away.
Lower away! Yay!
Bastard.
Stop, Spock! Stop, stop! That hole is ringing at me!
Stop! Would you look at those devils? Get after them, boys! Get after them!
There's pretty fellows! Let's give them rascals a run for their money! Yes! Yeah!
There she blows, lads, right at us.
Now, men, pull! Bring your lads! There's a fortune oil out there! That's your duty! That's what you're coming for! Duty and profit, lads! Hand in hand!
Here goes for a cool dive at death and destruction!
Bring your lads! Now, keep quiet. Stand up and give it to him.
A little more. You'll see more.
Sir.
Never you mind them, Flask. What difference who they are, Mr. Flask? The more the merrier, I reckon. Come on, lads. Long and strong, my beauties.
wood on skin.
See Mr. Flask, sir?
Nay.
Take me up, lads. Take me up. Flask! 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 You impious old smut! Where are you? There you are! What are you done finding there, sir?
The green! Stop! Stop!
You better fish him out, Mr. Stubb.
Before or after the sharks, sir?
Sharks wouldn't eat him. They'd take one bite and spit him out.
All right, let's go for him, gentlemen. Bag him off these foreigners.
Why is everyone so damn merry? We almost drowned.
That is whaling. Happen all the time, all the time.
So, punk, that's your first win, huh?
No more notes!
Damn, foreign monkey. Taking that rightful whale like that.
Oi, what manner of creature is it anyway?
Hey.
Creature from our dreams.
What do you mean? Like a ghost or something?
Aye, or a devil, perhaps.
Man's devil, all right. And the reason he can't see his tail is he tucks it out of sight.
What do you suppose he talks to the captain about? In that damn slithery tongue of his?
Striking up a bargain, I'd say.
That's it, Starbuck.
He's hard after that white whale, ain't he? Well, no, we think that devil's just trying to come round him, get him to swap away his silver watch.
Or his soul.
Soul?
All right, his soul.
Heaven help us. The vultures of the sea.
Why do we say Ishmael? Quick, no sabi this.
I mean that there's no savagery of beast that's not infinitely outdone by that of man.
Look at them devils, Mr. Stubb. Idling away while the rest of us sleep. Good man stole their boat and sent him to Davy Jones.
Oh, yeah.
Captain.
Sir, I must request that you put your foreign boys to work. Them sitting idle is affecting the morale of the crew. Did you not hear me, Captain?
They're not here as shipkeepers, Mr. Starbuck, or for any other business. They're here for one purpose: to find and slay the white whale.
Whale, hold! Sail starboard!
British.
Better welcome visitors, Mr. Starbuck.
She's swinging round!
Permission to lower boat, sir. The men deserve a short game.
Permission denied.
The captain, it's expected.
I'm Captain Ahab. Welcome aboard the Pequod, Captain.
Thank you, sir. We're a full ship, homeward bound.
I'm an empty ship, outward bound.
Then we'll make it good luck, sir. Some of my boys even won wives to themselves in the Fiji Isles, as you can see.
Aye, aye, Captain. Tell me, have you seen a white whale?
The white whale, do you mean? Moby Dick, some calls him. See this.
You've an arm that cannot hold, and I a leg that cannot run. The white whale.
The white whale.
So, it was Moby Dick took off thy arm.
And that leg. So he's a great bouncing whale, was he? Old as Genesis. The great milky white head on him.
Aye, and harpoons stuck all over his hump.
And a boiling rage.
Mine, sir, my harpoons. Tell me, spin me the yarn. How was it?
The surgeon did his damnedest, but he had to cut it off when it went black. Thank the stars I had my wife aboard. She gave me great comfort.
Aye, aye, sir, but the white whale.
Well, to the point. After he stole me bolts, we didn't see him for some time.
So you crossed his wake again?
Oh, aye, twice.
But you could not fasten.
Why would I want to? Isn't one limb enough? That white monster doesn't bite, he swallows. I have a wife on board and a profitable homecoming. Why should I take the risk? No, thank you, sir. No more white whales for me. He's best left alone, isn't he?
Aye, but he'll be hunted nonetheless. What's best left alone, Captain, is not always what least invites. When did you last see him?
On my soul, sir. I think your blood's at boiling point.
Which way was he headed?
Good God, east, I think.
East. East, east. Mr. Starbuck, prepare to set sail. We've wasted enough time. Good day to you, Captain.
What's wrong with him? He lost his senses.
My apologies, Captain Boomer. No offense, I'm sure, sir. It is the pain in his stump.
A man's mad. Away, lads. I'll not spend another moment on this ship.
Mr. Starbuck, prepare to set sail, you hear me?
Don't be a fool, Captain. Don't pursue Moby Dick. Beware, you demon. Beware the blasphemous end. Up, up.
Captain Cradle's coming over.
Sir Throttledy. Starbuck, damn you. ye set sail at once?
Nay, Captain, an hour, I beseech ye, sir.
At once, Starbuck!
I think the old man has lost a little of his wits.
Blast his eyes. He has no heart.
Ah, better a moody good captain than a merry bad one.
Come off there, boys! Come off!
Captain.
Now, now, Mr. Starbuck, you leave me be.
Perth do this, Perth do that. Why doesn't Doughboy get off his butt? Get off your butt!
Bubble there, second mate.
Nothing of concern, sir.
Keep it low, Mr. Burton. He started it. Quiet!
Captain, we probably won't see another ship for months. It was unwise to deny the men even this bit of recreation.
This is a whaling ship, Mr. Starbuck. This is not a society ball.
Off to the lookout.
But it ain't my watch, sir.
I cannot strike thee, Perth, but by my word, I'll see thee punished. I'll get thee aloft.
You needn't speak so harshly. God sink the lot of you.
I got my eye on him, sir.
Good.
Secure the line round the loggerhead. Nice secure! He cut one and nine!
They go down to the sea in ships that do business in great waters. These see the works of the Lord and
his wonder in the deep. Lord of all the seas, we here commend this mariner's spirit into thy hands.
So be it. We're born in throes, 'tis fit that we should live in pains and die in pangs and end in an unmarked grave.
To what end might that be, Captain? To the blasphemer's end, like the English captain said.
Life holds us, sir. We do not hold it.
No, I dare not question ye, Ahab. My miserable office is but to obey thee.
I only think I blame myself for this good sailor's death.
Careless sailor!
Nay, sir, 'tis an omen! An ill prophecy!
Prophecy. I'll give ye a prophecy, shipmates. Death to Moby Dick. And the fulfillment of that prophecy shall be what ye have all sworn to share with me. Death to my dismemberer, to Moby Dick. The gods knock me down. But I am up again. And now they take to their heels and they run, hiding from me. Come out. Come down from behind your cotton clouds. Come and strike me! I have no long gun to reach ye, only these! See if ye can swerve me! Swerve me? Ye cannot swerve me, else ye swerve yourself! Swerve me, never. The path to my purpose is laid with iron rails on which my very soul is grooved to run. And naught shall stop me, Mr. Starbuck!
Ah, she blows! She blows to starboard! The white whale!
He's raised the devil himself!
Thank you.
Is it wise to lower in the dark, Captain?
In the dark, Mr. Starbuck. We'll see his whiteness better than by daylight.
If I'd only one leg, he wouldn't catch me in a boat by night. Set may be to stop a leak with my whalebone toe.
He's possessed, I tell you. God has shipwrecked his soul. Now look at this. The fog. Where did it come from? And look at us rowing blind into it at night. Looking for a whale as white as the fog. Is that a ghost we saw or a whale?
It was Moby Dick, I tell ya. Fog, hail or snow. I don't care. I'll fetch that gold doubloon, or I'll die trying. Come on, pull it at me. Show some muscle, boys. Come on.
It's yours.
Hush.
Break ears. Listen.
Hold the oars, boys. Hold still.
Softly. That's it, mate. Softly now.
What do you make of it, sir? Sit down,
boy.
Yeah.
We got it. Come on.
Let her go down.
Turn around and take up that line, lad.
He'll drown, sir. He'll drown if we leave him there.
There are two boats in our wake, lad. They're sure to see.
Row, man, row! Put your backs into it. Pull, damn ye. Row! Aside! Set aside! Let me through! Row, you demons! Pull! Pull me to it!
He's there! He's there, I tell ye! Break your backs, men! Bring me to him! Beach me on his white back! Pull! Pull, you demons! Pull!
God, Dexter.
We've lost him. See him, Mr. Starbuck?
I did, Captain.
Why did you strike this whale when you could see Moby Dick?
I am a whaler, sir.
Got this blubber on board tonight. Before daybreak. We're driving on in the morning.
Aye, aye, sir. What about the boy, sir?
Boy, what boy?
Pip, sir. He's lost at sea.
Aye, sir. Seen him myself, sir. There's miles of sea between him and us now, sir. We can't risk losing this fine kill on account of that minstrel's foolishness.
Oh, Pip, you mean the tambourine boy?
Aye.
Aye.
What the devil was he doing in your boat, Mr. Starbuck?
Stowed away, sir, where he wasn't supposed to be. He's a kind-hearted, jolly little boy, sir, and I'm afraid we've lost him.
Me go find Pip. Pip be dead, that'd be bad magic.
Go to him, ye greyhounds! You have till morning to find him, Mr. Starbuck. He's what the sharks are left of him.
All right, thank you, Captain. Mr. Bulkington, take this crew and boat organize a search.
Aye, sir. Let's do it, lads.
Pip!
Where are you, lad?
You must all be daft. Looking for a black boy in a black sea in a black night.
off the cup in pieces. Let me measure it now, sir.
You man maker, carpenter, you measure me like a suit. I'll go. Cursed fate. That my soul should have such a house for a body.
Now, how does that feel, sir?
I can't say. I only feel what is not there.
Aye. This masted man never loses a feeling of his lost spar, sir. Now, careful, sir. Careful. Those straps there, and they'll break bones.
I like a strong grip, Governor. Something in a slippery world to hold on to. You ever hear of an old Greek called Prometheus?
No, sir. Can't say that I ever shipped with a man, sir.
Well, Prometheus it was that made men, made them whole, made them with tools. And he animated them with fire. Oh, Prometheus should have made me. What's made with fire belongs in the fire. Then I would have been complete. Oh, 50 feet tall in my socks. My legs like roots. Arms 3 feet to the wrist. No heart. Not at all. And eyes? No. A skylight atop my head, lighting up a whole acre of brains. Like a Greek god. Greek god. I stand on this broken stick of an old bone. My torn soul and my gashed body bleed into each other. And the truth shakes me falsely.
Thank you, Carpenter. The way do you fix it? You leave me to the gods.
Aye, aye, sir.
What do you want?
The dream has come to me again. Of my master's death.
My death? Well, then I pray you go before me.
I shall, as your pilot.
Well, then, my pilot, I pledge this. I shall slay Moby Dick, and I shall survive it.
Thank Ishmael and Quigway. They spotted him.
Mr. Ishmael! Mr. Kikwig! Ye are a credit to that ship, boys!
Hey, we missed ye, lad.
Hello, you lad!
Hey, lad!
Hey, come on!
Come on, sing us a song!
Pip, what is it, lad?
This be bad, Ishmael. This be very bad. Bad magic.
Ah!
Set sail, Mr. Starbuck. We wasted enough time.
Aye, aye, right away, sir.
Up sail! Let's catch a breeze!
Mast! Put them all up!
Spin away there, you lackeys! Do you not know he's out there? Thunder away at it!
Let's get this deck cleared!
Aye, aye, sir!
Clear it up!
We'll not be whalers again till it's Moby Dick's head hanging from this yardarm!
Hello, Pip. Brought you some food. Come on.
We ye day wrong bats. There, in there, two bones stuck in trousers. One be not ease, but a whale's. Gak! Psh! Gak!
I fear we should have left Pip to his fate, poor boy.
There she blows, Captain! It's white! The white whale!
It's not white, Captain! It's gray! Probably a humpback!
It's Moby Dick, I tell you! Unfurl the t'gallants! We need more sail!
Low, sir! Sperm whales off to starboard! Shall we lower away, sir?
Off all sail, Mr. Starbuck! We're driving on!
Sir, there's barrels of gold out there! With far more than a Spanish coin!
Those are my orders, sir!
But, Captain!
Sail on, I say!
Steady on course, helmsman! Sail onward! To nowhere!
That's it.
He'll not breach again for another hour. Mile away from here.
He's out there, my master.
Very near. Very near.
Ain't a cunning one, that Moby Dick.
If it was Moby Dick.
Huh?
But he'll make us chase him across the Antarctic if we let him. And when we're good and exhausted. But it's time to turn back. Ahab will say, drive on.
He's seen Moby Dick. He's looked again into that cold eye.
He won't let up now.
Cargo now, are we? Wasting our profit.
What good are our damn profits if we freeze to death? Sir!
Captain, might I be so bold to suggest that we turn north, sir, back on course, toward the Cape. There are no whales in these waters.
He's out there, Mr. Starbuck. He's daring us on. I've sailed through Greenland waters worse than this. We'll just force our way through this ice.
Aye, sir, but not at this time of year. The ice is too thick, sir. We can't take that gamble. It could crush the ship like a gourd, Captain.
Drive on, Mr. Starbuck.
Sir, Moby Dick's trackings are due east. You told me so yourself. Toward the Cape.
He's taunting us, Mr. Starbuck. He's taunting us. Drive on, I say.
I got it, Captain. Pack ice.
Oi, that's a bad sign. Shouldn't we be turning about, sir?
Captain's orders.
What's this? A mutiny or a speedy death?
All is not lost, my master.
ground. Now I ain't gonna die.
Back here, you bastard.
Let go of me. Let go.
Hey, Maggie.
Is it a fight you want, lads?
Well, the fight's out there. Moby Dick, my hearties. Have you so soon forgotten him? Well, hear this. Upon the day that white whale is killed, there is a piece of gold for each and every one of ye.
Moby Dick will not come to us! We shall go to him!
Yeah.
I do not order you, men! Ye shall will it!
Death to Moby Dick!
Merciless, untamed sea, Mr. Starbuck. But we'll not yield to it, shall we?
No, Captain, we will not yield to it.
Watch him in life and married a wife and damn it, she was lame. These away, all away, we'll all away go. She wouldn't stay home at night, which bloody dear drove me crazy.
All hail, Captain Pitt.
Everything but the eyes. Who are you, mister?
Peep, sir. Ship's cry, cabin boy.
Quiet, you crazy lunger.
Hands off his holiness. A greater idiot ever scolds a lesser. Oh, ye frozen heavens. Look down upon this luckless boy. He shall live in my cabin. So long as Ahab is alive. You're tied to me with cords of heartstrings, boy. You have touched the very center of me. Come with me. Come, come.
Blood on the thunder. Them two crazy ones now. Oh,
one crazy with strength, the other crazy with weakness, eh? A greater idiot am I than Pip, eh? Huh? Back to work.
I am sorry to disturb you, Captain, but the oil barrels are leaking.
Tie them up.
The cask wood is rotten, sir. It would be more prudent to ship into the next port and replace
them. We will not stray from our course, Mr. Starbuck. Is that understood?
We are losing our profits, sir. Do you wish to strip the men of all hopes of cash?
Oh, cash. That's a hard matter indeed. Tar up the barrels.
That will not do.
You mind your words, sir. Those are my orders. That is all.
As you wish, Captain.
Sail ho!
Where are we?
3 points on the starboard bow, sir! She's bringing down her breeze to us!
That's a cheering sight, sir!
Sails and prepare to board her, Captain.
No, Mr. Starbuck.
Have ye seen a whale boat adrift, sir?
Have ye seen the white whale?
Aye, we have, this morning.
Where was he, Captain? Not dead, was he? Not killed?
Ha, what does that matter? My boy, sir, I lost a whale boat. My own son is on that boat. I beg of ye, for God's sake, help me find him.
Oh, don't. No, 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 don't ask me.
I know you, Ahab. We have shipped together. Let me charter your ship, sir. I'll pay handsomely. You must. You must and you shall do this for me, Ahab.
The whale, Captain Gardner. Where was he when you last clapped eyes on him?
Ahab. I will not go till ye say aye to me. I know ye have a child of your own, safe in Nantucket. You know that I would do for you what I am asking ye to do for me. Yes, I see it. I see ye relenting. Stand by, men, to square away the yards. We're all going to look for that boat and find my son.
Avast! Touch not a rope yarn nor a block nose, sir. I will not help ye, Captain Gardner! Even as we speak, I am losing time, and I'll not lose any more! Mr. Starbuck, prepare to turn to windward!
No, no! No!
Come on, man the yards! Look lively there! We're sailing on! Goodbye, Captain Gardner! Goodbye! May I forgive myself, but I must go!
God will not forgive you for this, Ahab! He will not forgive you!
Helmsman, hold steady on an easterly course.
Quick, sailor, no more.
Your station harpooner.
Captain, he be bud magic.
Obey me!
Quick, harpoon no more!
Captain?
Captain.
Go on this door, Mr. Starbuck.
Permission to speak with you, sir.
Permission denied.
We'll speak to you.
You return to your duties, sir. Starbuck, get back on deck. Oh, by God, I swear I will deliver you straight to hell.
I am in hell. Captain, we have sailed for thousands of miles to stock oil. We are breaking a solemn oath by chasing this mirage of a whale. What will the owners think if we...
Owners? What cares Ahab? Let the owners stand on Nantucket Beach and out-yell the typhoons. They're not on my conscience. My conscience is in the keel of this ship. Now get back on deck.
Your conscience, sir, is drawing water. And in the end, it'll sink you down. And you'll drag us down in your wake.
Damnation, sir!
Good Lord, man, think of your men! The angels mob you with warnings. Do you not see them, Captain?
No, sir. Get back on deck.
Nay, I will not. I do entreat you, Captain. I only ask that we understand one another.
And listen to me, sir. There is one God who is Lord over the earth, and there is one Captain who is Lord over the Pequod. Now get back to your post.
As you wish. You needn't beware of Starbuck. Let Ahab beware of Ahab. Beware of yourself, old man.
You face me like a brave man, and yet you obey me. You're too good a man, Starbuck.
I wish I were not.
Queequeg, what's gotten into you? If you don't work, then you'll get a flogging for sure. Now, Queequeg, speak to me.
He got the voodoo element.
What do you think it is that ails him, Tashtego?
His spirit's ill. It'd be his time to die.
His time to die? What manner of nonsense is that? Queequeg, that's enough. Such madness. First the old man, then Pip, now Queequeg. Are we all to go mad?
It's Ahab, I tell you. He put the voodoo in all of us.
What the devil is this?
It's my friend, sir. He's not well.
Queequeg, put out that flame. You'll set the whole ship afire.
Ship on fire. Whole big ship. Ship all burn. And Queequeg go home's ancestor spirit to land. Get carpenter. I fetch him for you, mate.
What do you want with the carpenter?
Need him build canoe. Like them canoe put them in Nantucket whale are dead. Dark wood. Like me harpoon iron. Sabi.
What does he say?
He wants us to set him adrift in a canoe. Coffin. He's spoken to me of it before. It's how warriors are buried in his homeland.
Aye. So? What's he want?
A coffin that floats. Can you manage that?
Aye.
No matter! Hey, hey. Maori god, Nantucket god. No god on this ship! No god!
Thank you.
Pinkerton. Have you gone mad as well?
I got a young bride waiting for me, sir. It's not my fate to die with that man. I always liked you, Starbuck. Don't try to stop me.
For the missus. If you make it to Nantucket, though you haven't much of a chance.
Why don't you give it to her yourself? There's room in the boat. You'll need that more than me. God go with you, mate.
I said make fast!
It's the flask! Easy, sir! Fall together!
Flask, a word with you. Stop,
sir. I need a word with you.
What now?
Hey, now!
Now, come on. Let's take a few sips. You can get back to your prayers.
Don't just sit there and give me a hand.
Right.
Get in.
I've got to do a fitting. I've got to do a fitting.
Bless you, poor soul. Come on.
How do you mean,
usurpation?
A captain cannot use the ship for ill-gotten gains. Other than for the purposes of her owners, it's in the code of the merchant seaman.
We're not merchant seamen. We're whalers.
You're blind to what's happening here. All that we've toiled for is being lost, and he will not lift a finger to stop it. He does not care.
Careful, Stubb. This whole damn ship could go up in flames.
What are you proposing, mate?
We have the legal right to refuse further obedience. We can even wrest command of the ship.
Well, that's dangerous talk. I can't abide by it. Captain says, tar up them barrels. Let's tar them up.
Stop. Stop. Open your eyes, man. We're not whalers anymore. We're sheep. We're sheep following a madman, wandering from all mortal reason.
Right. That may be true. The captain's still the captain, and he's a fearless one at that.
Aye, a mighty captain he is. King of the seas and lord of all the Leviathans. We can't go up against that.
Hark ye well, mates. A fearless man is far more dangerous than any coward. No storm, no whale can match the terror that menaces us from the brow of this angry man. We cannot let Ahab's fatal pride drag this ship down to doom with him.
Mutiny, sir. That's an idea born of an undigested stomach. That's some killing ground you're standing on.
Aye. And I'll not be part of it.
This is a sharkish business we're in, Mr. Starbuck. Are you sharp enough for this?
I can no longer stand by to the willful murder of this good crew. I can no longer obey my God and obey him. Do you understand that, Star?
I understand, mate. But I'm not a religious man, nor a brave one. You stand alone.
Poor simple mad Pip. Oh, were I the wind, I'd blow no more in this wicked world. Oh, God. Stay my brain.
Oh, how he gores me. If only I could sleep.
But Ahab never sleeps. He only feels. Feels.
What is it?
A storm, Captain.
Mr. Starbuck, I know these seas and I know myself. Never think
Tie him down! Break the gallant sail! Come on, lad!
Jesus Christ in heaven, what's he doing?
Oh, he knows.
knows what he's doing.
Leap up. Leap up and lick the heavens. I leap with you. I burn with you. I command the heavens.
Done.
Ahab is bound, shipmates! Bound! Heart, body and soul! Life and lungs! And ye are all bound with the same oath! Make no mistake!
Captain! Captain! Mi Sabi! Mi Si! Mi Captain! Me, Captain! Me, God!
You see, Mr. Starbuck? You see? My pulse makes these very planks beat!
Enough, Ahab! No more witchcraft, old man! Prepare! God has turned against thee! This light is not thine! This light is not thine!
Look up, shipmates! Raise your heads! Look up and watch! As Ahab blows away the last of your fear! All of it! Gone!
May God forgive you. May God forgive you!
I just don't fathom you. You're going to die.
Ishmael. Only men go dead, want to go dead. No bad magic kill man, not want to go there. Only big fire, big water, big whale that don't think. Only that kill man, not want to go there. Sabi?
I'm going to draft my will. You can be my witness.
Quick, quick, much like that.
I don't mean to bother you, sir.
All right. What is it, Ishmael?
I don't know, sir. I have such a feeling of dread. What's gotten into this crew? They've lost their wits, sir. It's as if they cannot think.
They cannot see his madness. He won't let them. He won't let them think, only to feel. And they feel that they must obey him. I must obey him. And I hate him for it.
Then I must obey him.
No. Do not give in to him. Not in your heart.
I'm out of the head, sucking.
Aye, aye.
I make a coffin for Queequeg, but now he don't want it. And now you want me to turn it into a life buoy. Well, it's just plain undignified, that's what it is.
For God's sake, there's nothing else for it. We lost the old one. We need a new one. So stop complaining and just rig it.
Hammer a good yow, Wob. Don't want a leaky coffin.
I'll hammer your lips together if you don't shut up, you little black weasel.
No. Cook's right. You make a good job of it, for if this ship sinks, then there's going to be 30 lively men trying to get onto one coffin, and that's a sight I don't want to miss.
Here. Life buoy, Captain. Mr. Stubbs' orders, sir.
Ye are the leg maker, are ye not?
Yes, sir. So I am. So I am.
Are ye also the undertaker?
Aye, sir. 'Twas a coffin before, but now they've got me turning it into a buoy.
A buoy? You're a jack of all trades and as unprincipled as the gods.
I do what I do, sir.
Yeah, look at ye. Ye white-haired woodpecker, turning the dreadful symbol of grim death into an instrument of hope.
A coffin into a life buoy.
Faith, sir.
Faith? What faith?
Wait, faith. A sort of exclamation-like, sir.
Get this thing below where it belongs. Let me not see it again.
Sir.
You can tell me where I am, but not where I shall be. Where he is. Where is he? Moby Dick. You can see him, can't you? My eyes. Look at the very eye that even now beholds him. A foolish toy. Baby's plaything for commodores. What can ye do but tell me the poor, pitiful spot where ye be? Not a jot more. Ye cannot tell me where a drop of water will be tomorrow. Or where be the white whale. You're impotent. With your very impotence, you insult the sun! Curse ye! Ye vile, paltry thing! I will no longer guide my earthly path by thee! Oi, Matt, get below.
It's a mild, mild wind, Mr. Starbuck, is it not? And a mild-looking sky. The air smells as if it blew from some faraway meadow. Huh? They've been mowing hay somewhere under the slopes of the Andes. And the mowers are all sleeping in the new moon. Such a mild day as this, I struck my first whale. Boy harpooner of 18. 40 years ago. 40 years of privation and peril. Storms. 40 years of whaling. All those years, I don't think I spent more than 3 years ashore. 40 years of desolation and solitude. Whole oceans away from that young wife that I wedded. That I wedded and then set sail the next day for the Horn. Wife, did I say? Like a widow. She and that poor, sad, neglected spit of a boy. I widowed them both, Starbuck. With all the madness and frenzy and boiling blood and smoking brow, that with more than 1,000 lorens, I pursued my prey. More a demon than a man. And how much better, how much richer am I for all that effort? What is this? What is this master that commands me? What is this? An earthly thing that forces me to do what in my heart I would not dare. Oh God, I feel so old. He's gone. God meant this broken heart. Come closer, sir. Oh, God, I feel so deadly faint. Oh. Let me look into a human eye. It is better than to gaze into sea or sky, or even into the eye of God himself. No, 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 no. Stay on board. Lower nigh. I see my wife and my boy in that eye smoke. I see my home. I see my home.
Captain, in these eyes you see my wife, you see my children, and I fear I shall never see them again. Sir, let us sail from these wretched waters. Let me alter the course to leeward, sir. Let this fair wind blow us home to Nantucket. Show yourself to this man, or give me the strength to lift this arm against him.
Oh,
Oh, God, what have I done? Is Ahab no longer Ahab?
She blows! Down to the bow, Captain! It's him, the White Whale!
Come on, my children!
I shall not go with thee, Captain.
Lower the boats!
Then stay with the shipkeepers.
To the boat!
Fadala!
Come back, Keenan! Damn your soul! Watchmen, fire up those trade works! We shall have tons of blubber to burn tonight!
Aye, Captain, aye!
Gone before me, Fadala.
I am the Fates, Lieutenant. Poor man. Poe! Bring me alongside him!
Thunder away at him, lads! We'll strike him and send him to a fiery hell!
Oh!
see you moving dark!
Easy, man, easy! Paint Black Vomit Wrench Day! From the heart of hell, I stab at thee!
Little man. Thank you. Saved by my friend's coffin, I drifted on a soft, calm sea for 2 days and a night. On the evening of the second day, a whaling ship found me at last. It was the Rachel, still searching for her lost son. Instead, she found another orphan.